The Prime Minister talks about Beti Padhao and Beti Bachao. But look at this report. Young girls in the Warangal district of Telangana are dropping out of school to work in cotton fields. It's simple. When farmers can't afford to pay for labour, the first casualty is the girl child who gets pulled out of school and gets drafted into farm work. Uma Suthi reports on how this has now become a Hobson's choice for these girls.
Divya's father died and her mother suffers epileptic attacks, so she can't go to work. Monica supports her family ever since her father fell off a tractor and suffered serious injuries. Both these teenage girls dropped out of school to work on the field. They pick cotton from 9 in the morning till dusk to earn 200 rupees a day. That money will be used to buy rations and vegetables. Somewhere along the way, dreams got lost. Divya could not pay 1,000 rupees in time to enroll for training to become a nurse. There is a spark in Monica's eyes as she talks of her dream to become a beautician. Though she is not hopeful it'll ever happen. A short distance away, we found Mamta spraying herbicide on the field. But she refused to be shot on camera doing that. She knows about the Prime Minister's Beti Padhao, Beti Bachao campaign and is worried her school teacher will scold her for bunking school and going to work on the field. It is an open secret that in these areas, especially during cotton picking season, schools have lean attendance. Children as young as this child in fifth class are out picking cotton. Chandrakala's sons are still in school, but her daughter Lavanya has dropped out to work on the field.
When the earnings from agriculture is not enough even to pay the wages to the labor, what choice does a farmer have but to employ his own children on the field? It's a question of survival, and the first casualty is often the girl child. In Warangal, with camera person Nagraju, Uma Sudhir, NDTV.